We've been able to cover just about everything in the 70s in colour, with the exception of Ray Illingworth's match in 1970-71 at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Among the great players to tread the stage were Pakistan's Zahir Abbas with two double centuries, England openers Jeff Boycott, who completed 100 centuries, and Dennis Amos, who at some stage earlier had serious problems against pace bowling and then twice held at bay the mighty West Indians single-handed and with double hundreds. From Australia, there were memorable innings from the Chappell brothers, Greg at Lord's in 1972 was absolutely magnificent, and Ian at the Oval in 1975, then their double century partnership in 1972 also at the Oval is featured. Two West Indian stars really made their mark so far as the bowlers were concerned. Gordon Greenidge with three centuries in consecutive innings in 1976, and in the same year that magnificent cricketer Vivian Richards arrived. He hit a double hundred in his first test against England, followed by another at the Oval, made 829 runs in four test matches that summer. Sunil Gavaskar almost rewrote the record book, scoring 221 when India were 15 short of their 438 target in a fourth innings of a test match. England stars of the 80s announced their arrival in the 70s in a big way. Ian Botham, 8 wickets and 108 at Lord's in 1978. David Gower, 200 not out at Edgbaston in 1979. And for the bowlers, Bob Massey took 16 wickets on his test debut at Lord's. Deadly Derek Underwood, 10 wickets against Australia in 1972 and 13 against Pakistan in 1974. The West Indian bowlers matched their batsmen. In 1976, Andy Roberts took 10 wickets at Lord's and Michael Holding, that great fast bowler, 14 at the Oval for a series win 3-0, which made England grovel. But I can tell you the star of that quote, A.W. Gregg, the skipper, is featured playing very well indeed on this video. The great Australian fast bowler Dennis Lilly made his mark throughout the 70s with 10 wickets at the Oval in 1972 and came up with a total of 102 England scalps in just 9 years. Marvellous cricketer. On top of all that, we had the first two World Cup tournaments with memorable finals at Lord's, each of them won by the West Indies, who was skippered by Clive Lloyd. All that and much more to come, but first let's go back to 1970. After the cancellation of the South African tour of England, Ray Illingworth led an England team against a rest of the world side led from the front by the great Gary Sobers. It was a terrific series, but it wasn't Sobers who dominated it so much as the South African all-rounder Eddie Barlow, who was also vice-captain of the rest of the world team. Rest of the World won the first match at Lord's by an innings and 80. Barlow made 119, Sobers 183 and 6 wickets. Revenge for England at Trent Bridge, where they won by 8 wickets, Barlow 142 and 5 wickets. A quiet match for the vice-captain at Edgbaston, where Rest of the World won by 5 wickets. But then the storm really broke at Headingley, where Barlow took 12 wickets, including a hat-trick, and the first of the 7 he got in the first innings was Jeffrey Boycott.
And he's gone, and unlucky I would think, but this is a typical Barlow picker-up of wickets.
And that's a good delivery, it's a wicket, and Cowdery waited for umpire Rhodes' decision at the far end.
But that's it. Caught behind, so once again Sobers' move has been fully justified, and Barlow's picked up another wicket.
Oh, what a good delivery that was. Splendid ball that, and look at Eddie Barlow's face.
And he's still not going to be off the mark, so there's no doubt about that one. See the off stump, well back there. So that's Eddie Barlow's fifth wicket.
And he's got him. Great performance. Good Dinesh at short for square. Everyone around congratulating Eddie Barlow on this hat trick. He's done him again, 4 in 5 deliveries. Illingworth, inside edge.
Astonishing figures, 7 for 64 and 12 for 142 in the match. Gary Sobers scored 114 for Rest of the World and they won by 2 wickets. At the Oval in the fifth match, Graham Pollock scored a memorable 114 and Jeff Boycott 157. But despite these performances, Rest of the World won by 4 wickets for a series win 4-1. That winter, England, captained by Ray Illingworth, went to Australia, winning the 4th and 7th tests, both in Sydney. Australia needed 223 runs to square the series.
Bowled him. Played right over the top and Eastwood. Bowls Snow, no score. Australia, 1 for none. He completely yorked himself and Snow has staged a great breakthrough for Australia. Eastwood out for a duck.
And it's Lever bowling to Ian Chappell. There's an appeal for caught behind and he's out. Chappell is out. Caught not, bowled Lever for 6. Australia 2 for 22.
Is he caught? Yes, he's out. Redpath caught Hampshire, a very good catch indeed. Bowled Illingworth for 14. Stackpole not out, 49. Australia 3 for 71. Last ball of this over from Willis. Where's that going? Is it out to the boundary? Who's there?
Out.
Caught. Caught by D'Oliveira. Walters. Caught D'Oliveira. Bowled Willis for 1. An appeal to caught and he's bowled. He's bowled. Well, that bowled him around his leg, so Stackpole is out. There's trouble for Australia.
Bowling. Marsh hitting right across that one, and he is out. Bowled Underwood for 16. Australia 6 for 131.
This, of course, will be a great victory if England manage to pull it off, because they've been deprived of two of their stalwarts in batting and bowling in the persons of Boycott and John Snow.
Stumped. He's out. Yes. Well bowled, Illingworth. Chappell. Stumped. Not. Bowled, Illingworth. 30.
D'Oliveira to O'Keefe. Could be out court. Yes. O'Keefe is out. Caught at backward square by Shuttleworth. It's D'Oliveira bowling to Lilly. He's out court. Lilly staying there. Yes, he's out. Lilly not at all happy with that either, it appears.
Jenner facing Underwood. And that's it. Is it? Yes, he's out. That's the end of the match.
England won by 62 runs, taking the series 2-0 to recapture the Ashes on Australian soil for the first time since 1932-33. It was a great triumph for Ray. He's an outstanding captain and is deservedly carried off the field by his teammates. On the way home, England beat New Zealand in Christchurch by 8 wickets. Meanwhile, in the Caribbean, India beat the West Indies 1-0 with a stirring victory in Trinidad. In 1971, England played 3 tests against Pakistan and India. First, against Pakistan at Edgbaston, where Zaheer Abbas, in only his second test, was in prime form.
And he's coming for it. And comfortably home, Mushtaq following up. Even he throws his arms in the air. He's obviously delighted. He's going to run at the wicket himself and congratulate this young batsman who in only his second test match has reached 100. So Shuttleworth was a little bit unfortunate yesterday, had both these batsmen dropped. Superb shot on his toes, half volley, clipped away for 4. So what a good start again for Zaheer. It's a half volley, struck beautifully through the offside for 4 runs. Derek Underwood's giving chase, but no chance at all. So Ken Shuttleworth of Lancashire coming in again. Well, that's delicately clipped away down to long leg. 4 more runs to Zaheer. Perfectly placed, beautifully timed. It's Zaheer again. Now to face Basil D'Oliveira. And that's clipped away from mid-wicket as Luckhurst going to chase it. It's touch and go whether he's going to make it or not. Good sprint, and they're coming back for three, and those three runs takes Zahir to 199. Fine throw from Luckhurst from that very long boundary there at mid-wicket.
We've got the England captain coming on to bowl from the far end with the breeze. And that's four runs high up in the air over to the mid-wicket boundary from Ray Lewis, first loosener, and 200 he's got. And here they come, the Pakistani supporters rushing on to congratulate him. What a marvellous moment this is for this young boy.
That's 250 then to Zahir. Looked away the leg side for two runs, moving on to 251.
And what a glorious stroke through the covers off the back foot.
Zahir was finally out for 274, caught by Luckhurst off Illingworth, Pakistan declaring at 608 for 7, but despite following on, England managed to draw the match. Rain ruined the second test at Lord's, but Jeff Boycott scored his 8th test 100 in England's first innings. Here he is now facing Salim.
Well, that's the shot that we've seen a lot of in the last couple of years from Jeff Boycott.
Thank you very much. Four runs. Pass covers, right hand. That's through. And it looks like four runs and he's 50. That'll take some cutting off. Yeah, I think it's over. Boycott, I think it's fair to say, has missed absolutely nothing short-pitched on the offside. He's got hold of that one. That's a great shot from Boycott, but it's just short of the boundary at the far end. And he comes back for three. So Jeff Boycott now faces the last ball of an over from Asif Masood. That could be it. It's there. I think it's there. It is indeed. Boycott's 100.
Boycott was 121 not out. He scored 112 in the third test at Headingley, out after batting for 14 hours. England won by 25 runs to take the series 1-0. For India, draws at Lord's and Old Trafford, both of them rain-affected, took them to the Oval, where they gained their first victory in England. John Jameson, on his debut, was unluckily run out for the second time, and now, at 24 for 1, the Indian hero Chandrasekhar bowls to John Edrich.
Oh! Middle and off.
This is an uncomfortable period for Keith Fletcher, just three balls to go before lunch.
He's gone. Bat and pad, caught by Sulkar. What an over from Chandra. That must be lunch.
Well, it's gone up in the air and it should be a catch. And very easily and comfortably taken by substitute fieldsman Jayanti. Never in any trouble at all.
is out, he's caught Button Power, a fine catch, Alan Nod is out, Sulker's done it again, diving in from that forward short leg position.
So still these three short legs hovering just a few yards away from Illingworth, silly mid-off.
And he's caught and bowled. Full toss, driven straight back at Chandrasekhar. Oh, he's out! Oh, what a good catch! Venkat at slip, and look at Chandra. What a day. What a day for India. Just as the England captain went, so now John Snow. He's hit it away uppishly and it could be out. She's caught. Underwood is caught by Mankad. A nice running catch. She had about 10 yards, 15 yards to run in.
So the English overall lead 172 as Chandrasekhar comes into price.
And he's out, LBW.
England all out 101, Chandrasekhar 6 for 38, India won by 4 wickets to take the series 1-0. That winter, New Zealand achieved 5 draws in the West Indies. 1972, and the Ashes battle is on again. England won at Old Trafford by 89 runs, with 8 wickets going to John Snow. A new Australian hero at Lord's, Bob Massey. This test match has become known as Massey's match. Here, he bowls to Jeff Boycott.
Hold him! A good victory there for Massey, a good Yorker. And look at the breakthrough for the Australians. Look at the joy on Massey's face. And he's asking for that, and he's given it. It was the in-swinger, having bowled 4 out-swingers to Dolavira. Massey then slipped in the in-swinger.
Massey.
And that looked a pretty bad shot from Mike Smith. Playing across a full pitch, which hit the base of the stump. So another success for Massey. His third wicket.
He's out. A bad shot by Alan Knott. He guided that straight into Colley's hands at gully. Massey bowling to Tony Greig. He's gone. Must be out. Caught behind. He's given him out, and Greig is not particularly enamoured of the raised finger at the far end. Massey is bowling now to the England captain, Ray Illingworth, and he's bowling from the nursery end. And look at this delivery that nips back there in the air, strikes Illingworth on the pad, and umpire Constant at the far end has no hesitation at all in raising the finger. Well, that broke the partnership between Illingworth and Snow, a half-century partnership and a very good one for England. And here now is Massey bowling again to Snow. And there is the outswinger. Now, that really is fine swing bowling, coming on with the second new ball, this young fellow playing in his first test match. And here he comes in around the wicket, bowling again from the nursery end, still with the second new ball, and bowling to Norman Gifford. And Rodney Marsh, his first Australian teammate, takes the final catch that makes the final dismissal of the innings.
Massey 8 for 84, only 2 wickets for Dennis Lilly. Australia in trouble at 7 for 2 when Greg Chappell played what I consider to be one of the best innings I've seen. Basil Dolavira is the bowler.
It's a fine shot and he needn't run for that. Off the back foot, sweetly timed, 4 runs. Another beautifully played shot.
That was superbly well timed, standing up on his toes and turning the wrist on it, flicking it away just in front of square.
With Dolavira coming in, had a fairly lengthy spell, 12 overs straight off before tee. Once again, Chappell right into his stride, timing that beautifully, forcing it away off the back foot, wide of mid on.
Greg Chappell coming to his 50 in 3 hours, 7 minutes.
Chappell has extended his stroke play here today. He started off very slowly. A long time on 14, over 50 minutes. And then he started to play very well off the back foot. Having done that, he then launched into a series of front foot strokes, and he's looking quite good. That's Mike Smith. It's quite safe. It wasn't a particularly good stroke. It's gone for 4 runs. But Chappell was never over it. He was never inside the line. Tony Gregg. The 100 partnership between Greg Chappell and Edwards. It came up in 125 minutes. Well, he's got either 3 or 4 there. It should be stopped just inside the boundary, but he'll only take 2, I suppose. He'll want to keep Gleeson away from the strike in the last over. Takes Greg Chappell now on to 97. The offside field has come in, and that's a nice strike. You look for 3 here and you'll get it. The fieldsman's luck first. So they'll take 3 runs and it will give Greg Chappell the strike. The crowd rising to him at the moment. It gives him his 100, his first 100 in England, and a very, very fine effort. One stroke. Nicely timed. Greg gave him a long, hard look from the bowler's end there, but that really was a superb stroke. It's a fine shot. Lovely stroke, that. Boycott won't cut that off, I don't think. Just clicking into the fence now. It runs down the slope there.
Extremely popular cricketer with the English crowds. Fully aware that he's pulled England out of trouble so many times.
And he's done it again. A thick inside edge and Chappell is out.
Chappell made 131. Australia, a lead of 36. 2 more wickets to Lilly, and then it was Massey again. It's 18 for 2. John Edrich is the batsman.
That's a beautiful catch there by Rodney Marsh. And what a fine piece of bowling that was by Bob Massey. He deserved that one.
Massey bowling to D'Oliveira.
Step on or Greg Chappell. It's Greg Chappell. He's taken D'Oliveira. It's the 4th wicket down.
8 wickets in the first innings, and now at tee, 2 more for 8 runs. Bowling now to Tony Gregg.
And it's gone. Caught up for a slip by the captain, Ian Chappell. What a match Bob Massey is having.
And that's it. Alan Knott's gone the same way as the rest. And Massey takes yet another wicket.
Out! Stackpole at 2nd slip. Illingworth out. His 7th wicket down. Nothing wrong with the pitch. The pitch is a beautiful batting track. But he's doing it all with swing. Nothing happening off the pitch. He's cutting 1 or 2, but it's being done in the air. They're asking and he's gone, he's on a hat-trick. John Snow, first ball, glancing down the lakeside. Massey 6 for 35 in his 20th over. He's out. Edwards has caught him behind square leg. It was a good, authentic stroke. And Bob Massey now has become the first Australian cricketer ever to take 15 wickets in a test match. That's out. Greg Chappell, the man completing the innings.
Bob Massey, 16 for 137. Australia won by 8 wickets to square the series. There was a draw at Trent Bridge, and that brought the teams to Headingley all square, where on an odd-looking pitch, Derek Underwood bowled England to victory.
Oh, and that's a fine ball, and it's out, caught behind. So the 5th ball of the first over after lunch. That's a quicker one, he's out LBW. That's a one pushed through with the arm. And really caught Greg Chappell unawares there.
And that could be out, Illingworth's coming around under it. It should be out, quite safe. Marsh caught Illingworth, bowled Underwood, trying to hit the left-hander down the ground. He caught him! A great catch by Illingworth. It's out, outside edge, D'Oliveira. Greg Chappell, that's spun back a long, long way. Well, Stackpole is out leg before wicket to Underwood.
Look at that, Walters has gone. That one turn and lift in a fine catch by Parfitt. Really gave Doug Walters little chance at all.
That's Marsh now facing Derek Underwood.
Asking for a catch and he's given him out caught behind. And a little tickle. He's asking and he's given him out, a little tickle under the pad. Underwood on the hat-trick, 2-2, Inverarity out for naught, first ball.
It's bowling.
10 wickets for Underwood and England victors by 9 wickets in only 3 days. But then, Dennis Lilly took over at the over with 10 wickets.
And he's had LBW, I think no question, he walked and moved into that. And I don't think it presented too many problems for Bert Rhodes down there.
Bowl him, that's a good delivery. Middle stump out of the ground and Lilly again breaks through. It's out, first ball. Caught by Greg Chappell at third slip.
Australians reverting once more to Dennis Lilly from the Vauxhall end, coming into John Snow, looking for the extra pace here.
And getting that through and Snow's out caught behind. Marsh taking a very comfortable catch. That's the first ball from Dennis Lilly in this new spell.
Dennis Lilly now into Alan Knott. And Rodney Marsh takes the catch.
Edridge trying to pull his bat out of the road.
Dennis Lilly to Peter Parfitt.
Bowl him. Lilly again gets through Parfitt's defence and that looked to be a very good delivery. It might just have found inside edge.
And that's it. He's caught behind, going for another off drive. Was Tony Gregg perhaps carried away a little bit there? And he's out, LBW. So, not unlike the ball, in fact, which got Barry Wood up.
Dennis Lilly looking again for his fifth wicket in this innings.
And he's got it.
That, together with a 200-run partnership between Ian and Greg Chappell, gave Australia victory by 5 wickets to square a truly memorable series. England then lost to India 2-1, while Australia beat Pakistan 3-0 and West Indies 2-0. In New Zealand, Pakistan won at Dunedin thanks to a partnership of 350 for the fourth wicket between Mushtaq Mohammed, who made 201, and Asif Iqbal, 175, before they returned home to draw all 3 tests against England. Another split tour in 1973, firstly New Zealand at Trent Bridge. England made 250, then dismissed New Zealand for 97. The second time, only 2 players passed 10 for England, Tony Gregg with 139 and Dennis Amos 138 not out, and they declared at 325 for 8. England set New Zealand 479 to win, and they came so close to their first victory in England thanks to a wonderful knock by skipper Bevan Congdon. Here he is now facing Tony Gregg.
Once again off the bat, beautifully plays through the offside, that's 4 more.
Fine shot. Used his feet right to the pitch of the ball. Driven firmly through mid-on for four.
That's it. And a fine innings from Congdon. Boycott is the fieldsman. Coming away out to deep mid-on. And it's Bevan Congdon's 100. He goes on to 101 now. It's his fourth century in Test cricket. It's a lovely shot. Boycott won't cut that off. It's four runs. Nice footwork there by Bevan Congdon. And it's his 14th boundary. And that's a fine shot too. And that may well signal the end of Norman Gifford's spell of slow medium pace left arm bowling. Four runs, and Congdon stroking the ball beautifully now. Very powerful round about that cover point area.
That's up and over the top. It's in the air. Is it going to be safe? Lewis is coming round. He's under it, but oh dear. Never got a hand to it. I rather fancy it went through his hands. It's gone for four.
Arnold is the fieldsman at deep third man. And that is Congdon's 150. That's safe. Well now, don't think that went over Fletcher's head. I think it sort of went through the level of his hands.
And it's it. Bowled him. Jeff Arnold's broken this partnership. Congdon bowled by Jeff Arnold for a really superb 176.
Vic Pollard also scored his maiden Test century. England won by 38 runs, and then followed a draw at Lord's where New Zealand were again on top until Keith Fletcher, with 178, saved England. England won again at Headingley by an innings this time and took the series 2-0. The second half of the summer brought the West Indies, captained by Rowan Kanai. They won by 158 runs at the Oval. Then Kanai made 157 at Lord's to set the scene for the final appearance in England at the home of cricket of Gary Sobers, who left us with yet another great memory.
Beautiful shot by Gary Sobers. Really picked that up and clipped it away through mid-wicket.
Stroke. It really was wonderful to watch. The gentle defensive stroke, first couple of balls of the over, and then that really classic off drive. Got it away there, just through the extra cover position. Marvellous placement. Just rolling the wrist a little bit on that one so that it went finer.
Beautiful shot again. Four runs all the way. Good cricket there by this master cricketer. He'd been looking at this offside field. Another beautiful straight drive. Beats Fletcher, goes through for four. Brings up the 400. What a wonderful shot from Gary Sobers. Packed house here now, really getting full value for money. What a wonderful shot. You'd really have to see a lot of cricket to see a better shot than that.
it. The servers boarded by the England side. There is a modest invasion of the turf. Fine 100 then for Gary Sobers. His 26th Test match 100.
Six magnificent entertainment for a big crowd again at Lord's. More people on this second day than on the first. Very good humoured as well they might be, if they're seeing some really classic batting here by the West Indians.
Oh, what a magnificent shot. He fastened onto that like a panther. Not all that short. And the ball flew away off the middle of the bat, quite safely over the head of Boycott at mid-wicket.
It's to be Bob Willis, who has four wickets. And another four runs, a very elegant, gentle stroke, really, from Sobers. Shot square leg, scoring faster than 1 minute, 620 minutes. And it takes Gary Sobers up to 150.
A massive 652-8 gave them their largest ever victory over England, winning the series by 2-0. And in that match, all five England bowlers conceded 100 runs. England then went to the West Indies for the start of a remarkable year for Dennis Amos. In the first test, he scored 6 and 174 in Trinidad, despite West Indies winning by 7 wickets. He then held the West Indies at bay with 27 and 262 not out in Kingston, made 16 in the Barbados test, another 118 in Guyana, and a total of 60 in Trinidad, to give him 663 test runs in 5 games. By the 5th of April, England had squared the series, winning the final test by 26 runs, thanks to Tony Gregg's 13 for 156. In the third test of that series in Barbados, Lawrence Rowe made 302, and later that winter, Australia beat New Zealand 2-0 at home and drew in New Zealand, Glenn Turner making a century in each innings in the New Zealand victory in Christchurch. The summer of 1974 brought India and Pakistan to England, sharing the summer. Dennis Amos carried on from the Caribbean with 56 and 47 at Old Trafford, where England won by 113 runs, 188 at Lord's, where England captain Mike Dennis made 118, that was his maiden test century, as England made 629, including 106 from Tony Gregg. India followed on 327 behind, and then achieved their lowest ever total. Here's Farooq Engineer now, facing Geoffrey Arnold.
Must be close, yes indeed. That looked dead straight. Oh, bowl him, good delivery. Oh, what a great catch. Now there's a really fine wicket-keeping catch, and look at the elation from Geoff Arnold. There's a lovely delivery too, that left the right-hander. And there's the fourth wicket down. That one lifted a little bit, and Geoff Arnold is very, very happy.
Great catch by Alan Knott behind, the third he's taken in this innings. It's another wicket down for the Indians, and Abid Ali has gone for 3. And look at that. Yes. Well, Chris Old
knows the weakness of this young player, Madden Lyle. Doesn't really fancy anything short pitch like that. And that's it. No question about that. And he's bowling first ball.
Arnold 4 for 19. Old 5 for 21 as England won by an innings and 285 runs. Amos scored his 1,000th test run of the year in making 79 at Edgbaston, but it was David Lloyd who made the really big score.
It's a sweep shot again, which is going to bring him 50. It's an easy 3 runs here. It's a long way down to that boundary, and Amos comfortably into his ground. Lloyd takes 3, moves on to 52, his first 50 in a test match.
Nicely placed, Vishwanath, no chance of cutting that off. That's a good shot from David Lloyd. Rosanna just straying a fraction there, round about leg stump. That's a fine shot. Nice way to get off 87 with a straight drive. And that's a good shot. Beatty just got the fingertips to it. He didn't move slowly to it. He was across very quickly, but Lloyd timed that perfectly. And his 100 comes up now. A fine performance from this Lancashire captain. Really splendid effort in his second test match. Fine shot. Picked up the length of that very quickly. It was a faster ball. They even deliberately have been pitched a little shorter.
Another fine straight drive from David Lloyd, beating both mid-on and mid-off, converging in on it.
And again, a great stroke. Rosanna this time able to cut it off with the foot. And David Lloyd now goes on to 150. And that was the stroke worthy of bringing up that figure. That was a lovely shot.
It's cut away through the gap. And this quick outfield, which has quickened up quite surprisingly over the last 2 days, beating the efforts of both those two to try and stop it. So David Lloyd moves on now to within 2 runs of a double century. He moves on, in addition to a personal best, the highest score of his career. Single to Lloyd moves on to 199. Coming through, Fletcher doing a good job there, backing up well, allowing David Lloyd to get that single straight away, taking him on to 200, and that's a tremendous performance by the Lancashire captain, appreciated by this crowd here today and all the Indian cricketers.
Lloyd finished with 214 not out, and Mike Dinesh became the first captain since Peter May in 1958 to score successive hundreds as England won by an innings and 78 for 3 very conclusive victories. Just revenge for 1971. All 3 games against Pakistan were drawn, but at Lord's, Derek Underwood took 13 wickets.
Well, that's it. Caught at second slip or gully. The Underwood ball turning and lifting. Zaheer pushing forward and the second wicket down.
Sun shining, helping the bowlers now.
And that's another one. No chance at all there for Mushtaq. Turned, lifted, and Tony Gregg at silly point taking the catch. It could have got anywhere. It's gone to Amos this time. It's not a no ball. Asif Iqbal lost to go this time. Another wicket for Derek Underwood.
Oh, bowl him. A good, quicker ball by Underwood. That's good bowling, change of pace. deserved that wicket. Tendulkar too slow with the stroke. It's in the air, Tony Greig, the man. What a tremendous catch. Now that must go down as one of the really great catches of all time. That must be close. That one came back with the arm.
He had Zaheer caught by Greig for one, and now it's Wasim Raja taking strike.
And he's caught David Lloyd. Not a difficult catch, a good sharp effort by the Lancashire captain, and Wasim Raja not quite able to get over the top of that, trying to play it down, but David Lloyd is very, very good around the corner there. And that is out of the glove. Asif caught at short point by Tony Greig. Derek Underwood's fourth wicket. At a cost of 49. And he is as close to being unplayable as you'll see out there this afternoon. Oh, that's out. That's out, and a really nasty delivery. The only thing umpire Elliott had to decide was whether or not it hit the hand or above the glove. And Imran Khan is the man given out with the total at 200. Bowled him, and Underwood has four for none in five overs. The last five overs, Derek Underwood has bowled. He has taken four wickets for no runs, and he bowled Intercarb round his legs there.
Thrusting the pad down, he got a little nick and it's out.
Underwood took the final wicket, Wasim Bari LBW for one, to give him 8 for 51 and that match tally of 13 for 71. At the Oval, Zaheer Abbas made his second test century, once again a double 100, 240, in Pakistan's total of 600 for 7. Dennis Amos, having made only 37 in the first two tests, then made 183 to bring his tally to 1,253 runs in 11 tests. And then in Australia, he made a further 126 in the first two test matches to give him 1,379 runs for the calendar year, the highest by any England batsman. Despite that, in 1974-5, Australia beat England 4-1. England then beat New Zealand 1-0, while West Indies beat India 3-2, and drew against Pakistan. 1975 saw the inaugural World Cup competition with three memories which will stay with me forever. First, the onslaught by Alvin Kalicharan on Dennis Lilly at the Oval.
Four, he's flashed again, four more. Don't think Dennis Lilly will be as pleased as those spectators. That's a hook for four, and it's third bounce. Three fours in this over. And he's done it again.
Great shot. Beautiful back foot cover drive. A most talented batsman, this little fellow. Beautiful footwork, whether against the slow bowlers or the fast men. Lilly again. That's a beautiful hit. Magnificent hit, picked up from roundabout leg stump. And what an onslaught Kalicharan has launched on Lilly here this afternoon. Straight through second slip and four more. So once again the outside edge is brought into play. A rueful smile from Dennis Lilly there. is under that. It should be out. Yes, it is. It's the end of a marvellous little innings from Thanicharan. A real little gem of an innings of 78, which included 1-6 and 14 fours. That is 62 in boundaries.
Then Gary Gilmore with 6 for 14 and 28 in the semi-final against England at Headingley.
Well bowled, and that's out. What a good delivery. The in-swinger.
Big expanse of middle here, and having to use the same wicket again.
And he's bowled him. And Gilmore having a fantastic start here. And that's a brilliant catch, a beautiful catch by Marsh, taking it almost out of Ian Chappell's hands.
So Frank Hayes.
He's out, no shot. Well, that's a sad way to go. A fourth wicket for Gary Gilmore. What a spell this man is having.
There's another one whipping through, and he's out. Keith Fletcher, LBW.
And he's out. Another one gone. Alan Knott out for naught. 35 for 6, and Gilmore's sixth wicket.
And Clive Lloyd's marvellous innings in the final at Lords.
Effortlessly torn up his legs this time by Lloyd. Just going to beat Walker onto the ropes. Slightly downhill here at Lords, and with his quick out, feel the ball gathering pace the whole way down to that Tavern boundary. Magnificent hook shot out of the ground. Superb shot there by Lloyd. The West Indian crowd on their feet. No doubt at all about that shot. Beautifully played, in position so quickly. So Australia discovering here that there's another man they mustn't bowl short to. Really a brilliant hook shot for 6 there by Clive Lloyd, taking him into double figures. What a great shot, what a great shot. Stood still almost and hammered it away through mid-off for 4.
About about his 8th over now to Clive Lloyd. It's a marvellous stroke. Straight down the ground, landing just inside the boundary. 51 to Clive Lloyd. Quite a remarkable innings today, and appreciated by every one of his supporters in the crowd. And even by those who may not be favouring the West Indies here today. 50 in 59 minutes, 1-6 and 7-4s.
And that's hoisted away into the grandstand balcony. Tremendous blow by Clive Lloyd. Wasn't all that short, in fact, something like a good length ball, but picked it up, timed it sweetly. And he moves on to 73 and makes this partnership between himself and Rohan Kanai worth 100. And really hammered that square for 4. And there's no way you can bowl to a man like Clive Lloyd when he's in this sort of form. Length no longer means a thing. Not a bad ball by any means. Clive Lloyd now to face the last over from Max Walker. Away third, hurrying away to the boundary. That's 4 more. And the crowd unable to contain themselves, can't sit still in the seats. Half volley, and that's hammered away over the top. Ross Edwards chasing it, but it's 4 more. Really is a tremendous display of batting this. It's Gilmore to Lloyd. And repeated again, clipped away to mid-wicket. 4 more, he's found the gap so beautifully. And the crowd rising again to this West Indian captain, who's moved his score now onto 99. He got it in no uncertain terms. Beautiful flashing cover drive, typical of the man. The bat raised, the crowd on their feet. And what a delightful exhibition this has been by Clive Lloyd. You couldn't really wish to see a better 100 than that in any form of cricket. His 100 coming in exactly 100 minutes off only 82 balls, including two sixes and 12 glorious boundaries.
West Indies won that game by 17 runs to become the first World Cup champions. That was followed by a four-match series against Australia, who dominated the opening contest at Edgbaston, winning by an innings and 85 runs. Graham Gooch got a pair in his debut test. David Steele was brought into the side at Lord's, scoring 50 and 45, but John Edrich was the man of the match, making 175. Here he is facing Ashley Mallett.
Four runs. It was a good stroke. He gave himself a little bit of room there. Ian Chopper got his left hand to it.
That's going down. This is going to be his 100, I'm sure. Yes, he's running back for the second. And he's home. So John Edrich has got 100 for England. An unspectacular one, but a very, very important one indeed for England today.
That's a good shot. Much freer Edrich here this morning. Stroke that away very, very nicely indeed for four. Half volley on the leg stump. It was no real slog. It was a very good shot. Another beautiful shot for four runs. And this is exactly what England wanted. So Edrich, two boundaries already in a three. He's added 11 runs. And that's through the slips. Quite where he intended it, but it's going to bring four runs to John Edrich.
Good shot, four runs.
Max Walker then to John Edrich. And that's a beautiful stroke. Through extra cover. Well, that was another lovely shot. He played one very similar to that against Dennis Lilly in the last over.
30 overs have been bowled with this new ball, and Lilly's been in charge the whole time at that far end. 11 over spell this morning at the start of this over, 1 for 33. Edrich hoping himself a little bit. That will go through again for four. Eden Gilmour, no chance of cutting it off once it beats the field down there towards the Tuffin. So the 300 coming up, 303 now for three, with Edrich moving the score under 146. Lilly with one slip and an extra cover off the short run. Into Edrich. It's tickled away beautifully down to deep long leg. That'll go racing away for four more. It'll bring up 150 for John Edrich. And the crowd, another good one here today, on their feet, rising to the Surrey captain as he takes his score to 152 undefeated runs out of an England score of 309 for three. That's in the air, could be out. And it's the end of John Edrich. So after a great long battle out there, John Edrich finally falling to Ashley Mallett. Jeff Thompson taking good running catch at deepish mid-on.
That game was drawn, as was the third test at Headingley, partly because of two half-centuries from David Steele, who made 73 and 92, but mainly because vandals destroyed the pitch. Australia went to the Oval one up, where Ian Chappell played a splendid innings of 192.
Well, that's got away all right. Cut it all the way to four. So 50 for Ian Chappell. A remarkably consistent run in this series.
Woods, the fieldsman there, and they'll take possibly four run here.
Oh,
5 runs.
He's really a very long boundary here at the Oval. That's a very good shot. That wasn't all that far away from leg stump. It's 4 runs and 150 comes up. Greg just straying a fraction there to leg stump. Chappell really is very quick to seize on anything that's the slightest little bit offline. And there it is. 2 runs to Ian Chappell to bring up his century, take him on to 101. A very good innings from the Australian captain.
Picked away fine. Chris Owl, no chance at all of stopping it. So the 250 coming up on the board. And Ian Chappell moving on to 123.
Shot. 4 runs for that. Chappell hasn't always had his timing quite right today.
Old again to Chappell.
Oh, it's a good shot. Fine shot. Dropped just a little bit short. And Ian Chappell, a master of the square cut, putting it away quite beautifully for 4 runs, which takes him through to 150, 152 to be precise. Full toss, getting the right sort of treatment. That'll go through for 4, racing away through to mid-wicket. A short into Tony Greg's hand.
Australia declared at 5.32 for 9, England all out 191, but then Bob Woolmer, in his third test match, made a match-saving 149. Australia still took the series 1-0. During the winter, India drew with New Zealand and Viv Richards embarked on a sensational year. Despite losing to Australia 5-1, he scored 325 runs in the last 3 test matches and then made 556 in the West Indies, the Windies winning the series 2-1. With 881 runs from 7 tests in the calendar year, he arrived at Trent Bridge for his first test match in England.
He misses very little that's short of a length. Barely cracking that through mid-wicket. Short again. He must surely learn his lesson. Just never bowl short to a West Indian batsman, particularly on a slow pitch such as this. Early sting has gone out of the wicket here now and it looks absolutely ideal for batting. Short again, and similar sort of treatment, and another boundary. That's short, pulled away again. And Richards has never yet missed out on this short ball.
Shot, and pretty well fielded by Hendrick. He got the hand to it and took quite a bit of the pace off it. It's still going to go for 4. But he did well to get down to it and get a touch on it. It was a fine stroke from Richards. Toss and 4 runs. Underwood not able to get to it, so 8 from this over from 2 spanking drives from Vivian Richards. Good shot. Beautiful stroke that.
It's
classic straight drive.
Hammered away unmercifully through the offside. Really hit with tremendous power. No need to run for that one. Over pitch ball. Big wide gap there between the bowler and mid-on. Richards finds it, takes four more. His 14th boundary. And moves his score on now to 86. Oh, what another good shot. Really was a fine shot that, fully admittedly, but beautifully placed, perfectly put away by Viv Richards. What a way to go to the 100. A really superb shot. Half volley, pitch round about leg stump. Barely clattered again through that onside. So a magnificent 100 by Viv Richards. Bringing some more glory to the Antiguans who are here in full support of him today. It's already his 600 in Test match cricket and his fifth since January the 1st this year.
Great shot. What a magnificent stroke. That is the stroke of the day. And there's another four, and it's a great shot. Could have gone over the top. Just made it over the rope. Tony Greig now bowling to Richards. Oh, great shot. Beautiful strike. And, when he attacks, marvellous certainty in his stroke play. So 250 comes up now for Kalacharan and Richards, their partnership.
Well, that's short, that's it. Friendly offering on 196, am I word, by John Snow. Pitched it halfway down. And a tremendous performance is by Vivian Richards. 200 in a test match on this ground, following in the footsteps of the great Frank Worrell and Basil Butcher before him. And, of course, his first 200 in a test match.
Richards was finally out for a magnificent 232, West Indies 494, and for England, David Steele was the hero.
It's a good start for David Steele. First ball after lunch. Lovely, crisp stroke through the covers for four. But certainly four runs.
Full pitch, tucked away nicely. So it won't go through, it'll just be cut off inside and closest turning, coming back well, and it's three runs to David Steele, moving on to 52, another really valuable innings by the Northamptonshire batsman. England then on the way to recovery here.
Good shot, no need to chase that, it's gone into the crowd at forward square leg.
That's a good shot. It's firmly clipped away by Steele, and that's going to beat the field through. Did everything exactly right there, David Steele. Well over the top of it, timed it quite perfectly. That's a good shot. Full pitch. Put nicely through mid-on, a long chase there for Larry Gomes, that'll beat him through to the boundary. And the 200 coming up for England, 203 now for three. Andy Roberts coming in from the far end. That's hooked away down to deep long leg by David Steele, a fine shot. Well, he'd be grateful of that on 93 and moved into position exceedingly well. Trying in with another one to hurry for the single. Well, a misfield there by Robertson. They shouldn't come. Yes, he's coming back. He's chancing his arm and he's a dive full length and he's made his ground. Well, he survived. Was it all really worth the risk? That's it. It's a no ball. Firmly dealt with for four by David Steele. And my word, if any England batsman has deserved 100 in a test match, it's got to be David Steele. He's absolutely delighted. His hat's raised in the air. Been acclaimed by the Union Jacks in the crowd.
Steele out for 106, with England making 332 to draw the match. Viv Richards didn't play in the draw at Lord's, but Andy Roberts returned a bag of 10, and the first of those was Barry Wood.
And that's out, Barry Wood on his way, tried to pull his bat out of the way, couldn't manage it. Barry Wood misses out again here in a test match. He's out for 6, Andy Roberts strikes the first blow for West Indies, and England lose their first wicket with a score on 15.
That is great concentration. A good slower ball and he must be out. That's good bowling from Roberts. A lovely slower ball and Steele was beaten on the backstroke.
And he's bowled him. Beaten there by a little bit of extra pace. And Roberts strikes again for West Indies. Mike Fairley, who'd held out all this time for his 40 runs. Beautiful piece of bowling again by Roberts. Collects his third wicket, really out for 40. And the England score on 115 for 3. And he's caught him, and a great bowling change. Roberts has done it again. He's come back. A brilliant catch there by skipper Clive Lloyd, getting rid of Tony Gregg. Out for 6. Another failure for the England captain. It's Andy Roberts' 5th wicket of the innings, rounding off a wonderful day's bowling by this West Indian pace bowler. It's John Snow, the man to go, without opening his account.
Oh, what a great catch that is. Pure reflex, but a superb catch by Ralph Jumadeen. That was a forcing stroke by Pocock, and a good one too, from which he may well have picked up 4 runs. Andy Roberts now bowling to Woolmer. Woolmer's on 29. And that is out. The 4th wicket down in the England second innings. Bob Woolmer in the second over after tea, caught at the wicket by Derek Murray off the first ball of Andy Roberts' first over. That's in the air and it must be out. Yes, it is. The hook shot again is done for David Steele. Ralph Jumadeen taking the catch and Steele's cap falling off as he played what was a very good bumper from Andy Roberts. And that must be very close indeed. Yes, it is. Alan Nott has gone and Roberts has taken his 4th wicket of the innings. A fine spell of bowling, Andy Roberts. Alan Nott, LBW, to Roberts for 4.
And it's all over. No need for Tony Gregg to declare. Underwood clean bowl comprehensively there by Andy Roberts, ending England's innings on 254.
The series then turned as the West Indies took control at Old Trafford. Enter Gordon Greenidge.
Hendrick now to Greenidge.
That's short, that's hooked away. 4 runs. And once again, anything that Hendrick drops the slightest little bit short, this man takes full advantage of.
It's a fine shot. He's played 2 of those today.
one off Hendrick, straight down the ground, just on the onside, and that's the second. Four runs. And the 50 up for the West Indies. That powerful square cut from Gordon Greenidge. And four more. Two very short deliveries from Bob Ulmer. Great effort from Frank Hayes. Just got his fingertips to it, but it's gone for four more runs.
Greg to Greenidge.
Well, that's beat mid-off. Going through for four. Over pitch ball. That's Gordon Greenidge's eighth boundary as he moves on to 54. And it won't do anybody any good. Could have used another 2 minutes there. We're in a fierce cover drive there by Greenidge. It's a nice friendly half volley, and Greenidge never seems to miss anything pitched up or anything dropped short. It's a friendly full toss on the leg stump. No bother at all to Greenidge. Clipping it away through mid-wicket for yet another boundary.
Great shot. Beautifully timed, that for four runs. No chance of Wilmer cutting that off. It's his 11th boundary, Greenidge, in a total of 66. And it's Mike Hendrick. Four runs. Not a very good delivery. Hendrick's been disappointing this morning.
Oh, that's another fine shot. Enormous power he gets out of all these strokes. Follow through, the rapid outfield there doing its work in the end for Greenidge. Bringing another four, taking him on to 95. And in any form of cricket, Derek Underwood is an intensely difficult man to get away. He's already bowled 10 overs for just 19 runs. And it's over the top, and that's what Collis King was trying to do. It's a glorious shot over the top of mid-off. Four runs, the four runs that Gordon Greenidge needed to complete quite a brilliant 100. And there can't have been very many better 100s than that when you think in context of this West Indies innings, that he's made his 100 out of a score of only 146 for 5. Tremendous performance. It's his maiden test century against England. It's come in a shade over 3 hours, included 15 fours, and is only the second test 100 of his career.
An astonishing 134 out of 211 by the West Indies. England all out 71, holding 5 for 17. Greenidge made another 101 in the second innings, the second West Indian to score a century in each innings after George Hedley at Lord's in 1939. Viv Richards then scored his sixth century of the year with 135, with the West Indies winning by 425 runs. On to Headingley, and Gordon Greenidge made his third successive century against England, the first to do so since South African Alan Melville in 1947. John Snow took his 200th test wicket, but the West Indies still made 450, followed by a spirited fight by England, led by Tony Gregg.
And gloriously driven through the offside. Not a particularly quick delivery, that. It was a little bit of a loosener, wasn't quite a half volley, in fact. But there was a big wide open space there, which Gregg found very confidently indeed. And that's a fine shot. Lloyd giving chase. If anybody can catch it, he will. No, it's beaten them both. So the four that Tony Gregg wanted, the hat already off, claiming fine ovation from this crowd here at Headingley, going through to his first 50 in this Test series. Couldn't really have come at a better time for him.
And that'll be four. Just a little defensive push, but that really was running very fast away again from Lawrence Road. And another very good looking stroke, a better one that time, even though Bernard Julian will just pick it up inside the boundary. Good shot, four runs. .200 comes up and the crowd loves every moment of it.
That's a good shot, no question at all about that. Right off the meat of the bat. Daniel de Grey. Oh, that's a good shot, full toss but nicely tucked away. Tony Gregg moving on to 84. Oh, glorious shot. The half volley. Successive boundaries there now taking Tony Gregg. Really the master of the situation at the moment.
And he's in trouble here, and he's missed it. And that is Tony Gregg's 100. It could so easily have been a run out. A complete misunderstanding there between Gregg and Alan Knott. Tony Gregg goes to his century.
116 for Tony Gregg. The identical score was made by Alan Knott in England's 387. When Viv Richards batted again, he passed Bob Simpson's record of 1381 runs in a calendar year in his 10th match. The West Indies won again to go two up. The final test at the Oval with Viv Richards in complete command. Here he is facing Geoff Miller.
Swept away behind square. Certainly be his 100 this. Richards knows it. Takes the first one comfortably, jogs away for the second to complete another brilliant performance. It's 100 coming here in just on 3 hours, including 10 fours. And really is a man in form. It's his 8th Test 100. Oh, it's a good shot for four. Again, the overpitch wide-ish half volley. Just a little bit too far outside off stump.
That's a fine shot, beautifully placed. Just racing away over the parched outfield there. Shot. What a good shot.
Beautifully placed. Gave himself room. It wasn't all that short. But this man Richards is so quick on his feet. He seizes and sizes up the opportunity so quickly. A magnificent shot again. Ran away from it. Played it late. Crushed it square. So up goes about 150 to Viv Richards in the 77th over now, and in some previous Test match days that's as many as we got all day. Still an hour and 20 minutes to go here. A bad ball short and taken full advantage of again by Richards. Hammered away through mid-wicket for four more. So 300 total reached, with only two men out, and Richard's share of that is 157.
David Steele. safe and four runs. Good clean hit too.
And that's four more, no bother at all. Richards disdaining to leave the crease, stood there and hammered it away. And that's it, flipped away nonchalantly and elegantly, and unfortunately we're going to get an invasion which will spoil this really brilliant 200. So Richards going on to a second double century in this Test Match series.
They've made 291 as the West Indies totaled 687, and the only Englishman to hold them at bay was Dennis Amos, who scored a superb 203 in his comeback.
Four runs. Four more.
It's a catch, but it didn't stay in the fingers. I think it just flicked the hand as it went through, but it's given Dennis Amos his half century. A good comeback.
One's also got to remember, of course, that Lloyd has kept an attacking field the whole time, nobody back on the boundary. And Roberts again to Amos. It's a fine shot. Over pitch ball, into line, cracked through mid off the four.
83 facing Andy Roberts. Good shot, four runs, takes him to 87. Dennis Amos is on 91. He's now on 95.
Amos in fact on 96 now as holding moves in. And that could be it. Over pitch ball, driven through mid-off, hurrying away. Julian's given up the chase, it goes through for four. And a tremendous comeback this by Dennis Amos. Recalled for this England side, one or two people having serious misgivings about his ability to deal with the pace. He's answered him in the best possible fashion. Going to a really excellent 100 out of 168 here for three.
Fine shot, four runs. That's a better one. Great stroke.
Richards keeping going at the Vauxhall end. And that's four all the way. Bad ball, the first really bad one from Richards, pulled quite viciously through mid-wicket by Amos. Short again. And that's through for four more. Amos waiting for that one, dropped short of a length, fairly cracked it through mid-wicket, moves on to his 150 now, 151. That's through the offside for four, cracked away off the back foot, and that boundary to Amos brings up the 300, 303 now for four. And Dennis Amos' personal contribution to all this is now 176.
Great shot. It was in the air. It went past that man like a rocket. And that also is four. And it's his double hundred. It was over Greenidge's head. Dennis Amos goes to 203. A superb effort.
England totaled 435, but Michael Holding took a total of 14 wickets for the match. The first of those, Bob Woolmer.
And he's out, LBW this time. There's a danger man, Holding.
That's out. David Steele has given out LBW. Ernest Bolin played on. A very, very good Yorker, that one. My word, that's a good piece of bowling from Holding.
Tony Gregg facing Holding. And he's bowled him. So Holding strikes again. And a very disappointed, disenchanted Tony Gregg there.
Bolin beaten for pace there. There was a quick delivery from Michael Holding to remove Derek Underwood, the night watchman.
And there's Bolin. He's gone over too far. He's left the leg stump wide open. And Dennis Amos out for 203. The man to strike again, Michael Holding.
Well, it's still persevering at that far end with Holding.
And he's played it on. And another wicket for Michael Holding.
Slim it off, forward short leg, the backward short leg.
And he's done it too, Olive. Yes, he's got out in the identical fashion, would you believe it? An inside edge, first ball. Holding's got eight wickets. Selvey goes, first ball.
Holding to Amos.
And that's an edge, and that's taken, and he's caught at second slip. And there's the extra pace of Holding. And he's out, I think. It's on his way, yes, caught behind. A little touch again. Ball didn't move a great deal. Holder's got rid of both openers now.
Oh, it's a lovely rhythmic run, acceleration, and then that beautiful last three or four strides. And what a great delivery. Balderston, a pair, and a superb piece of bowling. Oh, well, bowled. What a great Yorker that was.
And he's bowled too, and Holding's done it surely this time. Out of the ground goes Alan Knox, middle stump. And that has really got to be the end of England here in this fifth Test match.
Man who's really destroyed England in this Test match. Holding to Willis.
And that's out, and it's LBW, and it's all over. Holding takes the wicket.
The West Indies took the series 3-0, but what an amazing summer for Viv Richards. 829 runs in four Test matches to total 1,710 runs in the year from just 11 Tests. A hectic winter followed with all countries playing. England beat India 3-1 on their way to the centenary test in Melbourne, where there were two main stars. For the bowlers, Dennis Lilly with 11 wickets, the first of which was Bob Woolmer.
Is that it? Yes, it's carried and he's gone, and Lilly snapped up the first wicket, that of Bob Woolmer. Caught a slip with the total on 19.
And chance, and caught, yes, by Hooks. Well, a great breakthrough for Australia. Really, the regular opener is out. Caught Hooks, bowled Lilly for 12. 2 for 30, Lilly 2 for 11.
And Lilly to Randall.
And that one he reached, and he's caught behind. Yes, he's out.
Randall, a very fine edge. Court Marsh bowled Lily for four.
Lily now bowling with the southwest breeze. Lily perhaps has not swung the ball very much in this particular game. He's made it go off the seam, but he'll be bowling across old towards the slips.
And he's happy to go. Off like a shot, Crisol. First ball, lifter, a little touch, caught behind. No problem at all for Dennis Lily.
He's a fearsome looking fellow, isn't he, when you get a close up? No wonder the bird batsman sort of fall to him, 4 for 25.
And he failed the leg before, he's out. And a chance, he's out, it's all over. Marsh again, a brilliant catch. Marsh has taken four catches. England all out, 95. Lever caught Marsh, bowled Lily for 11. Lily 6 for 26. One of the greatest performances of his career.
Lily followed that with 5 for 139 in the second innings when England needed 463 to win. Now enter the batsman, Derek Randall, to play a great innings with some typical play acting.
Oh, thank you very much, he says. Oh, this is nice, isn't it? Friendly game of cricket.
Oh, fine drive. Plays that shot so well. I think Davis can give that chase up. And they're going for a run. That's his 100. Magnificent effort. Randall, Derek Randall, 100 in his first test against Australia. A very great effort indeed, and it's been a fine innings throughout. And they've all called, and out to the boundary it goes, but right inside that and racked it right at backward square. Randall, 107.
That was a glorious shot.
Quite a half ball, struck that on the up, placed it to perfection between cover and mid-off, and it races through for another boundary for young Derek Randall.
Beautiful shot. Perfect piece of timing again by Derek Randall, just lent easily and casually into it, and once again finding the gap through extra cover. He's loving every minute of it. Took him by surprise. He, for a change, let that one go.
And perhaps the chance was over the head of the fieldsman. It was between the cover and the mid-off. It was in the air and it was lofted for four runs. Well, more runs. That's hook shot, a good one too, is going square with the wicket. Only two fieldsmen on the onside, and Randall goes up to 139, 2 for 277. And finding that gap again, a brilliant shot off the back foot from Randall. That's going to be four. Davis had a great dive for that, but couldn't make it. And Randall once again has showed that great placement. He has that ability to put the ball where he wants to in the cover area.
Another really glorious drive. That should beat the fieldsman. Got the extra little bit of power. And fairly hammered away through the cover area by Randall. Once again, fractionally short. He's beaten for a second time, and Greg Chappell asking, and he's given him out. And it's Rodney Marsh. Yes, agreeing. There was some doubt, I think, initially as to whether that ball had carried, but the end of a marathon performance there. And is he being recalled? There's some doubt as to whether that ball carried. And I've an idea that Rod Marsh initially said he didn't think it carried. The umpire gave him out. He's coming now to consult with Max O'Connell, the other umpire, and they've told him to stay. Well, that's a very generous
piece of cricket there by Rod Marsh.
And through the covers, what a glorious shot. He thrashed that through as a fine cover driver. And the field for caught, is he? He's walked. He's gone. Randall, caught by Kozier. And there's a wonderful innings. I'm sure he'll get, this man will get a standing ovation for this extraordinary performance of scoring 174. One of the finest innings we've seen in years and years on this Melbourne ground. And the player, Derek Randall. And everybody here is standing up to give him a tremendous ovation as he comes back to the pavilion after an absolutely fantastic match.
A memorable match won by Australia by 45 runs, exactly the same result as way back in 1877. 1977 brought Australia to England. The first test at Lord's celebrated the Queen's Silver Jubilee, and Bob Willis celebrated with 7 wickets.
It's out. And it's a loose stroke from Greg Chappell, one of the few he's played, and Chris Old is the man taking the catch. Chappell is out for 66, caught Old, bowled Willis, and Australia are 135 for 3.
Willis to Sargent.
And he's gone. Well, one of the worst balls that Bob Willis has bowled here all day long. Very wide, very short. Sargent going for the square cut, just getting a faint deflection through to wicketkeeper Alan Knott. So Sargent goes for 81. The fourth wicket is down for 238. And my word, he's caught it. It seemed initially that flicked off the pad. It was off the bat. Walters goes. Willis picks up another wicket.
Well, that's got to be close. Yes, indeed. I'd have thought that was absolutely plumb. Good delivery from Bob Willis. The fourth wicket with his second new ball. Marsh is out.
That's an edge, and it's taken this time. So a much Walker go, snapped up by Alan Knott off the bowling of Bob Willis. That's short, it's a catch. And in the very safe hands there of Alan Elam, Bob Willis collects his sixth wicket of the innings. Kerry O'Keefe caught Elam sub, bowled Willis.
And there's no more need for conjecture about that, because Bob Willis has turned in his best ever bowling performance in a test match. He now has taken 7 for 78.
Bob Woolmer followed 79 in the first innings with 120, and the match was drawn. Woolmer carried on the next test at Old Trafford with his third century in 4 innings against Australia in England, and the home side won by 9 wickets.
Steered nicely through the slips, no chance, played it down and gets 4 runs.
Quite an authentic stroke. Yeah, there's no nick about that. That's 4 more.
Short, bad ball, 4 runs. Bob Woolmer making the most of that.
They need to chase that. It wasn't a very good delivery, shortish outside off stump. That's where Woolmer's strength is, and that's the 100 partnership. And the well deserved burst of applause from a big crowd here at Old Trafford. Beaten Davis, and it's a long, long chase for Max Walker, and the outfield is very fast. Only the 3 runs. Walker did well to cut off the 4 there and just saved the 1 run,
And Bob Woolmer has gone on to his half century, and a very good one it's been too. Beautiful shot. Well, it wouldn't have mattered if Kokoschka had been on his feet or not there. In the air, safe, and four runs, and that is Bob Woolmer's century. He goes to 103. A splendid performance. The last Englishman to hit centuries in successive innings against Australia was Ken Barrington back in 1965-6. And Woolmer has now hit his third 100 in Test cricket, all of them against Australia.
At Trent Bridge, Ian Botham made his debut, and Alan Knott made his highest score of 135.
Good shot for four again. That was all along the ground, and it wasn't an edge. It was, I suppose, meant to go a bit squarer than that, but Alan Knott got it away very nicely. And it's to be Geoff Thompson bowling to Alan Knott. Four runs, no chance of cutting that off. Good shot. That's not far short of the best shot of the day. It wasn't all that much over-pitched. Alan Knott was waiting for it and fairly slammed it through the covers. And that's Alan Knott's 50. A most valuable inning for England. It's also the 100th stand. These two experienced players. The one who's been a stalwart for England in recent years as wicketkeeper batsman, and the other making a comeback to Test cricket, having last played against Australia in 1972. They've pulled England's innings together again, and look at the determination on Knott's face. Four more. Would have needed a reflex action to pick that up. It went very fast. Equally good stroke, a little more unorthodox, because Knott gave himself some room there.
A short steal away again by Knott, gave himself room, chopped it away. Four more to the little Kent wicketkeeper, who's really brought this crowd to their feet. Following it, chopped away fine, and O'Keefe doesn't quite know where to pitch it to him. There's no margin of error whatsoever on this pitch for the slow bowler, and anything just fractionally short, Alan Knott has moved away and chopped him away to third man. And it's steered away on the ground for four runs. So both Balatsman and collected a boundary in the first two overs. Not quite, I don't think, where he intended to go, but it fairly raced away down to that Radcliffe Road stand. A little bit of pressure here again. He's made 100 against Australia in this country. Has done it overseas. He's on 99 as not as Thompson comes in. That's away, he steered it nicely down to third man. That's the single that he's been after. This crowd rise on their feet to applaud. Superb performance by Alan Knott.
England won by 7 wickets. Geoff Boycott returned to the side and duly scored his 99th 100, which set the scene for another at his home ground, Headingley.
That's a lovely shot. That's his first boundary. Typical Boycott shot, that's the shot he plays so well. Oh, that's a lovely shot for four. First really bad ball that Walker's bowled, and
Well, he got so quickly to latch on board.
For 20 minutes. Four runs to boycott. Good shot through mid on. There's a gap, a wide gap from the bowler to mid wicket. Another thick edge. Water boycott takes him into the 40s now, up to 41. Towards that record of being the first man to hit his 100 in a test match. Goes on now to 52. Greg is 8 and it's 129 for 3.
Straight drive before by Boycott. Slower ball and Boycott reacted very quickly to it. So that straight drive by Boycott takes him on to 65, establishes the 50 partnership now between Boycott and Greg. Beautifully placed shot. Start to the half volley, a loosener, and once again Boycott very quick to latch onto it. That's driven very firmly and very correctly through the offside. He's cut away square pass slip, bottle race down for four also. And that's through this time. And a glorious cover drive by Boycott. And it really has to bring the best out of him, this, because this is a fairly closely packed offside field that Bright's bowled into. And it requires really expert judgment to find the gaps. That short, it's hooked away, it's in the air, but it's going to be safe. And a good shot, in fact, by Boycott. He got into position pretty smartly, pretty quickly there. Takes him four runs nearer. And, Geoffrey Boycott just waiting and hoping for a nice half volley outside off stump. That's it. That's a half volley through mid on for four. The bat goes in the air. The England players come out to applaud what really has got to be a moment here of cricket history. Geoffrey Boycott, 100 hundreds. The place to get it in the middle of a test match against Australia on his home ground at Headingley.
Boycott finally out for 191. England won by an innings and 85 runs, and a draw at the Oval gave them the series 3-0. Again, a busy winter, but England suffered under Jeff Boycott's captaincy their first defeat by New Zealand, thanks to Richard Hadlee, who took 10 wickets.
Oh, sparring, and he's caught brilliantly by Mark Burton, that second slip.
Hadlee again.
And this time he's gone, caught behind. So the long, painful innings of Graham Roopers at last come to an end, and fittingly, it should be Richard Hadlee that takes his wicket.
Botham also fell to Hadlee, caught by Burgess, and now Chris Old takes strike.
And bowled. To
And he's looked at that one, it's going to be out.
To Hendrick.
And England lose their eighth wicket, 8 for 53.
What a fine, that's the one they wanted. Phil Edmonds, Richard Hadley pitching that ball up.
Again a stab, he's gone, that's the wicket that's wanted. Taken by... The stumps are going right, left and centre.
From one all-rounder to another. Ian Botham against Pakistan, a century at Edgbaston, where England won by an innings in 57, and then he came to Lord's and made another century.
No need to chase that. You set those close in fields, you've got to be bowling very accurately. In the air, and quite safe. Hit away well wide of Haroon Rashid and Ian Botham now. Has gone on to his half century.
So both them facing on 82. That's driven fiercely once again for four runs. Absolutely lethal he's been here today on anything slightly overpitched. And hit him with such tremendous power, he's never afraid to lift or loft the ball. He's succumbed to both. And greet him with a full toss too, and both of them make no mistake, he will in middle that through mid-wicket for four. So that four bringing up the 300. And that could go through. Speaking of one, they beat them both, and it goes through for four, and again the both of them bat is held high up, and what a record this young man is establishing. That's his third Test match 100. It's on his seventh Test match. And he made 100 in the last Test match at Birmingham. He made one prior to that in New Zealand.
Now, Botham, the destroying bowler.
Ah, that's gone. Well bowled, Ian Botham. He almost did it in the last over with a big leg cutter. And that one lifted and went away from Madassa. The second wicket is down. Madassa out for 10. Court Taylor bowled Botham.
Edged away and beautifully caught again. That's the perfect outswinger, and Tullatully goes. It's Graham Roop snapping up his second catch.
Oh, what a good piece of bowling. Well, it's a great over this, and the perfect culmination for Ian Botham. And he's gone, he's picked up his fourth wicket, and Wasim Raja driving a little too early. Is the sixth one to go down for Pakistan with the total at 119. That was a bad shot. Good catch by Bob Taylor.
And he's caught it. It's another very good catch indeed. Went very, very low off the outside edge. Botham takes yet another wicket. Sikander, the man to go, out for just a single. There's no question about that one, though. That one swung in. He's only left one stump standing. A great sight to any pace bowler. A great sight for Ian Botham, as his figures now stand at 7 for 30. And that's it, and the Test match is over.
A win by an innings and 120, followed by a draw at Headingley, gave England the series 2-0. Both of them returned to Lord's to take 11 wickets against New Zealand for the series, 3-0 to England. During the winter, Pakistan won 2-0 at home to India, 1-0 in New Zealand, and drew against Australia, with India beating West Indies 1-0. England, however, beat Australia 5-1. 1979 saw the second World Cup, the West Indies again in the final against England. This time, Viv Richards was the hero. The West Indies won by 92 runs. And then India played four tests. At Edgbaston, England won by an innings and 83 with an elegant double century from David Gower.
That's a beautiful shot. No need to run there. Overpitched and found that very big gap there between mid-wicket and mid-on. Fairly raced away to the ropes.
You can't bowl that sort of stuff to have Gower's quality and expect to get away with it. No matter how many men you have on the onside. It's a good shot. Kick a ball from Chandra.
And there he goes, pushed comfortably through mid-off. Chandra not able to stop it, and David Gower through for 100. First-class exhibition from David Gower. Situation was made for him. Not had a great time with the bat this year, but there's no place like a test match to find your form.
What a great stroke. There's a certain amount of contempt in that. A bit casual and just stroked it away rather than hit it.
Well, Venkat coming in for the Gower treatment now. He's given Kapildev a spell at the far end, comes off in, on himself, and is put away immediately for four square on the offside. And again, beautifully placed shot. On the back foot, you can't afford to drop anything at all short the Gower. That's a quicker one. Waited for it, cut it later this time. And that two will race away for four.
Possibly the hardest David Gower has hit a ball in this innings. He normally relies solely on timing, but he really launched himself at that one. Showed good judgment today, Gower, in the ball that's pitched just that little bit short. One of the best shots he's played. It was shortish, but I know a few players who might have been playing it straight back down the pitch. David Gower's on 172. Great stroke. He really flat batted that away through cover point. It's 21 boundaries to Gower now.
That's a delightful shot again from Gower. Beautifully placed. Short, it's hooked away, but hooked away safely. There are two men back there at deep square and long leg, but once again Gower has placed it right between the two of them. And he's got a thickish edge, that's going to race away. And 200 runs to David Gower.
Draws at Lord's and Headingley, and then at the Oval, Sunil Gavaskar was the hero. He almost won the game single-handed with 221 when India required 438 and fell just 9 runs short.
Splendid stroke to bring up the 100 for this fine batsman.
Please stay off the wicket.
100 to Gavaskar.
It's a beautiful shot. Half volley, admittedly, but put away in really glorious style for extra cover.
It's a lovely shot from a slower ball, very well picked up. Gavaskar quick to seize on that. That's his 12th boundary. And there's his 150. That's a great knock. 150 out of 253. Beautiful innings from Gavaskar.
He's gone, hit that over the top. Cleared the ring of inner fielders for 4 more.
And another 11 to make the highest score by an Indian in this country. And there's 4 of them. The rare occasions that Peter Willis dropped it short outside the off stump, and as we've said repeatedly, this little man very, very seldom misses a loose ball.
Here's his 200. A super innings. Magnificent performance.
Concentration.
200 out of 324, 431 minutes, and he hit 19 boundaries. It's the third double century of his test career, and only the second 200 made by an Indian player against England. Well, that's what happens when the luck's running with you. Nicely fielded by Butcher. Gavaskar has equaled highest ever test innings by an Indian player. That little edge stroke past leg stump.
Well, a superbly placed shot there by Gavaskar. Saw the big gap there between long on and mid wicket and smacked it right in the middle. Records and achievements going by the board here. At single takes Gavaskar on to 221, his high score in Test match cricket, beating the 220 he made against the West Indies at Port of Spain in 70-71 season. And he's gone. So the end of Gavaskar. Botham comes on and does the trick. Gower takes a catch at mid-on, and is that the end of Indian hopes? Well, it's certainly the end of one of the finest innings we've seen here at the Oval for many, many a long day.
To end this summary of the 70s highlights, a final look at one of the stars with his innings of 138 in the second World Cup final, the great Vivian Richards.
That's a super shot. Beautifully positioned. No nerves about that one for Viv Richards. Best shot today. Right out of the textbooks, that one. It's arrogance at its best, that one. Unless the batsman happens to take things into his own hands and hits her over the top. One thing you can't afford to do with a field like that is bowl short with a short boundary on that tavern stand side. That's how short the boundary is. No chance there for the fieldsman at mid-wicket to get across in time. Phil Edmonds is the man trying to get around, and he's been kept a bit square now.
Well, a little bit of luck there on 49, but he gets four for it off a thick outside edge. Both of them are delighted, but it's been a fine knock this by Viv Richards. Goes to 53 out of 109.
A super shot that is. He just picked it up and hit it away over deep square leg for six. There's a certain air of contempt about that.
Oh, that's a friendly full toss, and he's got it away. That's going to be his 100, yes. Beautifully plays to full toss. A joyous Richards, a delighted West Indian contingent here. And Viv Richards going through to 101 out of this total now of 243 for five. Hadn't been in the greatest form in this competition and was a little bit sketchy when he came in, but he's recovered his form, and this is the old Vivian Richards.
Very wise indeed. Who wants to be a hero at that stage of the innings? Last ball of the 60th over. Viv Richards on strike. He's finished it off nicely with a six. It's a tremendous shot.